with some incredible V8 noise. I gotta hear it again. Yeah! Woo!
Hey crew, I've got the key. And yes, it is in fact a physical key to this Velocity Modern Classics Ford Bronco. We are going to take it for a drive, but first, let's check it out how it looks on the inside and outside. As a quick download on Velocity Modern Classics, they take vehicles like this 1974 Ford Bronco and they strip them down all the way to the frame, straighten out the body, build it back up, powder coat it, and make it look cherry while adding in some tasteful aftermarket parts. So up front, we've got the classic grille with the red Ford lettering. They've added in things like these LED headlights, and then we've got the incandescent turn signals on the inside. Below those is a chrome front bumper, and they painted this truck in a beautiful Porsche cream color. You just don't see colors like this out on the road, and I love it. At the side are 17-inch Pacer chrome wheels with center locking hubs wrapped in BF Goodrich 32-inch all-terrain tires. And within those wheels are Wilwood brakes, 6-piston up front. There's your Bronco Sport badge. They added these awesome build aluminum door mirrors and door handles. And stepping back to look at the profile, just a timeless shape. And it looks so good on that 2.5-inch lifted Bilstein suspension. There's also a 6-point roll harness and a safari top to match. At the back, if you know the 74 Bronco, you know this view. It's Ford lettering on the tailgate. They added the Velocity badge there. You've got a chrome lower bumper and incandescent tail lights with turn signals. You can drop down the tailgate from here to reveal a rhino guarded bottom and these woven floor mats. This truck is just a stunner, but I gotta know from you guys, which looks better, this classic Bronco or a new one? Let me know in the comments. And let's check out the interior next. Opening up and letting the power side steps come down, revealing a gorgeous cabin with these high back chairs covered in walnut leather with diamond stitch patterns on them. On the doors, there's that Porsche cream mingling with the walnut leather and this build aluminum for the armrest, for the door handle, and for the roll-up window control. You've got a kicker sound system here, more of those woven floor mats, aluminum accenting for the accelerator pedal, this wood rim for the steering wheel, and chrome for the arms. To get into the back seats, you gotta pull this lever and the seat goes forward, and then you slide it forward and move it out of the way. All right, so it's not that easy to get back here, but when you are, you've got plenty of leg room. This is with the seat all the way back. There's a map pocket, you got your speaker, and I have plenty of headroom underneath the safari top. So that gets the thumbs up from me. In terms of amenities, there's the fresh air. Moving back up to the front, we have an integrated grab handle. And with that side step, it's very easy to hop into the driver's seat. Door close noise. Oh, that classic metal on metal thwack. Your gauge cluster is here in build aluminum with a speedo and tachometer. You've got a tilt adjustment for the steering wheel. Your wiper controls are there. And then in a build aluminum, we've got your lights and your climate control settings. This is an aftermarket Pioneer sound system. It'll pop out the head unit and reveal a backup camera. We have more of that walnut leather up on the dashboard and leather wrapping for your 2-speed transfer case controls. More of that rhino guarding material for the console with your 2 cup holders. We've got a USB A and C port, and then under the leather wrapped console, we have quite a bit of storage. Visibility? Well, we're not so worried about modern crash test ratings, and instead we just have that roll bar, so you can see all around this truck so easily. You don't need that blind spot monitoring or rear cross traffic alerts. You've got your eyeballs. This is a stunner of a cabin. I can't wait. Let's take the Ford Bronco by Velocity Modern Classics for a drive. All right, let's fire it up. Such a good noise. And the beauty of a modern motor cranks on right away. Selecting our gear here on the tree, pulling it down into reverse, and that should present the display with a backup camera. See if I can get it to come out. Huh?
There we go. Of course, you don't really need it because you can just turn your head down into drive. Let's listen for the turn signal sound. Doesn't really make one. But I like the satisfying click of working the indicator. Let's try for the turning radius test. Some complaints from the power steering, but a small wheelbase does mean we can pivot around real easily. World famous horn test. Whoa, okay. That's a horn. Let's talk about the motor. So, in the 1974 Ford Bronco, you had two powertrain options. The lesser of which was an inline six-cylinder that made a whopping 75 horsepower. And the more potent of which was a 302 cubic inch V8 that made 137 horsepower. Either way you slice it, by modern standards, not a lot of power. So, instead, Velocity Modern Classics gives you a 5-liter Coyote V8 that makes 480 horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque. It's made into another modern thing, a 10-speed automatic gearbox. And the application here is excellent. Velocity also adds their own unique serpentine system, headers, and performance exhaust. The throttle response, there is no drive mode to choose from, is very perky. You will have to adjust to that. But when you're at speed, the 10-speed auto is very smooth. The suspension seems to create imperfections in the road that aren't there. But you know what? I kind of love it. I love bouncing all over the place because it makes me feel like I'm driving an OG 74 Bronco. This is kind of the vibe you would have. You just sort of bop all over the place. So I'm glad that it's here in this Restomod product. With this Safari top, not a fully enclosed hard top, there's a fair amount of wind noise that gets in. And of course, wonderful V8 exhaust music. This is with the glass up on both sides. If you crank it down, I feel like it's more appropriate. You just pop the elbow and cruise. And that is something that this Velocity Modern Classics Bronco does very, very well. It just cruises. The Wilwood brakes, shockingly easy to modulate and come up to a smooth stop. It takes about a third throttle to get up to speed. You've got so much motor. And when you're up to speed, manipulating this wood-rimmed wheel is such a pleasure. There's some play in the middle of the steering, but as you add lock, get a decent feel for it. And while everyone else is appreciating the eye candy of the exterior of this Bronco, you get to savor the interior delights, the visual beauty, the magnificence of this cabin. Ah, it's just such an all-encompassing pleasure cruise. And that's kind of the magnificence of a Restomod product. You get on the outside the look of a very classic vehicle. And the interior does that as well, while gussying up certain things that you can appreciate, like the billet aluminum for the window control. I mean, it's like, it's such a perfect blending. And then the driving experience is downright perfection for a person who savors the drive, for a person who loves all the analog things about classic vehicles, but wants to be able to keep up with traffic. I mean, if you're driving around in just a restored 74 Bronco, even with that V8, you're gonna have to hope that everyone is patient with you, and there might be places where you would be downright afraid to drive it. This oh my gosh, that sounds so good! This is not something that you would ever be afraid would have trouble getting up to the pace of traffic and then maintaining your speed. And then just like that, you peel off the throttle a little bit, you let the 10-speed auto do its thing, and you're breathing in the fresh air. And that's just it. I debate all the time whether I should be showing more older vehicles on this channel. But my genuine fear is that I've been sullied so much by modern refinement and performance that I would go into that and walk away feeling like, yeah, I get why this is great. And I love the analog details and the feedback and all those things. But it's hard to transcribe that into the modern era. And that's why a Restomod, I think, perfectly pulls at my heartstrings. You get everything you love about classics with the one knowledge that your vehicle is going to start up every time you crank it on, and then two, it's going to behave with the confidence inspiring abilities of modern braking and modern acceleration, and even to some extent, I mean this less so, modern handling. And that is the perfect cross section for me. And this is totally unnecessary, but I am going to do a real world 0-60 test in the Velocity Modern Classics Bronco. I've got my race box set up here. As you might expect, there's no launch control, so I'm just going to put my foot hard on the throttle and we're going to see what happens. Here we go. Oh, good Lord. Ha ha ha! 4.5 seconds! With some incredible V8 noise! I gotta hear it again! Yeah! Woo! There's nothing keeping me from hearing that V8. We've got the top open. The glass is thin. I'm sure the firewall is paper thin. It's just you and that V8 and this incredible truck. Gosh darn it, this is cool. Oh. Let's see your 74 Bronco do that. I don't want this to turn into the Miles therapy session, but guys, I really needed this. Look at that! Look at this! I needed this drive because hopefully, as you understand by now if you've been watching my channel, I do this because I love driving cars and I love bringing you guys into it. And this vehicle right here just helps stoke that passion in me so much. Thanks for joining. What is a Velocity Modern Classics Bronco gonna cost you though? Quite a bit of coin. You gotta pay to play, guys. So the way it works with them is you give them a donor Bronco. It honestly doesn't matter what condition it's in, thankfully, because they're tearing it all the way down to the bare metal and then building it back up. But still, the chassis for a Bronco, a classic Bronco right now, are very expensive. Now, they will take over your VIN number, and so it kind of continues as if you still have your Bronco, but built up quite a lot. But then from there, you need a budget like 200 grand. That's kind of the starting point for the Velocity Modern Classics Bronco. And this vehicle, as tested, with some of the billet aluminum touches and that Porsche cream exterior color, is $227,000. Now, the good news is that if you have in your possession that donor Bronco and you got the money, then you can make this finished product happen pretty quickly. They've got a 14-week timeline for their production line assembly. So you give them the goods, you give them the money, and they'll tear it down and they'll build it back up within 14 weeks. And then you've got something that is so unique. I mean, yes, there are competitors to Velocity Modern Classics. The one that comes to mind is Icon 4x4, and they do build a really solid product. I've toured their facility. It's very, very good. But beyond the people who do this day in and day out and have so many different examples to show for it, if you're trying to do a sort of kit job resto mod, it's not going to come away as the solid, polished product that this vehicle is. We interrupt this message to bring you a DeLorean. How often do you see one of those driving around? It must have just been because I'm driving something special that it felt like it had to gravitate towards other special things. But a DeLorean, guys, rad. If you love the classics, but you want modern performance and reliability, and if you want to have as much fun driving something as I am right now, then it does not get much better than this right here. I want to hear from you guys though. Would you go with just a classic restored Bronco? Would you get a resto mod like this Velocity Modern Classics? Or would you spend your money on something newer and perhaps more insulated? Let me know in the comments, and I hope you've enjoyed this POV first drive. If you did, please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel, hit that bell to get notified, and I'll see you next time.